Testing, testing. 1, 2, 3.
Living the sweet life.
Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another video. And today I'm going to teach you how to make little iPods for your American Girl dolls and iPod cases with little pop sockets on them. And yeah, this is a closed pop socket. So, yeah. This one is hot glue, and it's a little bit more durable, but the other one is polymer clay. And, yeah. So, the little iPod, our copier is out of colored ink, so it's just black and white right now. So, yeah. Okay, so what you're gonna need is this. If you have like an Apple device or something, I think it comes with this. All of them, it's like a little direction. What you're gonna need to do is copy that or just get an image offline and print it out. But I just copied it because that's all I have. So yeah. So you would have copied that out, and once you copy it out, it should look like, let's see, where's my copy of it? So it should look like this, and yeah, our printer's out of ink, colored ink, anyway. If it was out of ink, then I couldn't have been able to do this video. Okay, well, anyway, so now you cut that out. And get some foam board and just put it on and just do a basic outline of it, of the foam. And now get glue dots, put 3 on the back, and just stick it onto the foam board. And now you're going to have to cut the excess off of excess foam board, so it's cut the excess foam board off just like that. There we go. Okay, so now you're gonna get some packing tape. Where's the edge of it? Can't find the edge. There we go. Okay, so put a vertical piece of tape on it, or horizontal, and then you just fold that in to make it look shiny, just like that, and do a vertical piece like that, so you cover up all of the edges. Now you just clip off the excess with your scissors, the excess tape. That's good. And now if you want to add more detail, you can just add a little bit of little camera. That's bad. There we go. Okay. That's add a little camera, and then you can also add an Apple symbol or whatever symbol you want. You can even make up your own symbol. But, oh, that's really bad. Well, anyway, you can even add a home button if you want to. But, yeah. So, for the cases, you get plastic wrap, fold it into, just fold it in fourths, and wrap it around your iPod so there's a little bit of space between the case and the iPod. And now get your hot glue. You're going to need like a piece of plastic, and just for the edges, just hot glue on the edges, and get your piece of plastic, and just put it on there so it's flat and not bumpy. I mean, you could do a bumpy if you want to, but. And now for the back, just cover it up with hot glue. And just stick it on there. And you just need to wait until it is dry. Hardened, yeah. Let's see. It takes a little while for it to dry. And I took it off way too early, so don't do that. Just a little bit of glue at a time. So, yeah, just do the sides. and stick it on there so it's nice and flat and more professional looking. You just need to wait. Yeah. Okay, I think it's about dry now. Just take it off just like that. There we go. Okay, so yeah, that's good. And now just do this with all the edges and I'll get back to you. So now what you're gonna need to do is do the back and just do a little bit of glue at a time on the back, not a lot, or else it'll be what happened to me, and just let that dry so it's nice and flat on the back. So I'll get back to you when I've done all the back. So I've done all the back, and now we just need to try and get the case out of here, or the phone out of here. Just, you know, you can rip the plastic wrap a little bit, just like that. You know, you just need to get the plastic wrap all out of the case. Just carefully peel it off, and oh, that's a little bit of a mistake. Let me fix that up. So I've got the case all fully intact. I fixed it up. And now we just need to cut the little camera hole in the thing and trim up the edges also. Just trim up the edges so they're nice and flat. And now just cut a little square rectangle for the camera. And be careful with the X-Acto knife. Mm-hmm. And just like that. Oh. And just pop it out. Let's see if it's good enough. No, still need a little bit more. A little bit more space. Just a little bit more space. Oh, I'm just gonna. There we go. And I think that's good. Yep, that's good. Okay, so there's your case. And now we just need to paint it. So I'll get back to you. Okay, so I've got the paint. And this is a stubborn one to get open. There's dried paint. I'm going to use my X-Acto knife. Just like that. Oh, a little bit too much, but that's fine. And just squeeze all this white out. There we go. And just mix up the paint. Just like that. It's more like a purpley pink. It's like magenta. Well, anyway, so just paint your case, all of it. Just paint all your case. And yeah. So, yeah. So, now I just need to let it dry, and so I'll get back to you when it's dry. Bye! Okay, so it's the paint's dry, and now we're going to make the pop socket. So, yeah. And this one is a closed pop socket, which is a lot more simpler than that one. But we're just going to learn how to do the first pop socket. But, yeah. So first you get black foam about the size of that, like just like your thumb, or to fit in your American Girl's palm, just like that. Yeah, just to fit in your American Girl's palm like that, just like that. Hi, Hannah. So you have to cut out a circle. Yeah, well, I mean, you can cut out any size you want, I guess, but it's just easier to make it bigger, I guess. So yeah, you just cut that out like that, and yeah, you can do it with your X-Acto knife, but I recommend scissors because it's pretty hard to do it with an X-Acto knife. I mean, you can outline it and stuff, but it's just harder, it's just easier with scissors. So yeah, I'm just cleaning the edge up because I sort of messed up. But, yeah, so I'm just going to get my scissors, just cut it out. Sorry if you can't see me. Yeah. So, yeah. So, yeah, just cut that out just like that. Yeah. Okay, I'm just going to get back to you until I make a perfect circle that I'm satisfied with. Okay, so I made a perfect circle, and now we are going to have to just, yeah. Okay, so, yeah. So, get your circle, and now you're going to have to put a dot of hot glue right in the middle of it, and just like that. And now, okay, so it's dry now, and just you have to put another dot of hot glue on it, and just get some, like, water or spit or something on your finger, and just push it down like that. And you're going to have to do another one, a little bit wider this time, I think. And you're just building it up and making it wider as you go. Ouch. That hurt. I burnt myself. That hurt. Oh, okay. Well, anyway. So a little bit wider, and now do one a little bit more wide. So we're just building them as they go, as I said earlier. Yeah, just get spit on your finger. It's probably not a good idea, because I would burn myself. Well, okay, so anyway, yeah, just build it out more wide as you go. More wide, a little bit more wide. And just wider, 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 wider. And this time, we should, yeah, just hold it upside down so it's taller, so it gives us more to work with, just like that. And maybe at the end, to make it flat, you just put it on your plastic. So, yeah, now you just need to wait for that to dry. Yeah. Just dry, 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 dry. Okay, just put a little glue there. Come on. Okay, there we go. Now it's dry. And now, just put a strip of glue even more wide. Sorry, Natalie keeps dropping things. Yeah, so even more wide. And, yeah, so sort of like a little pyramid shape, sort of. So, yeah. Okay, so our little thing is wide enough now. And now you need to just get some green foam, or just foam, sorry, I'm using green, but, and just cut a circle out the same size as your black one, and, yeah, just like that, okay, that's a little bit, yeah, you know what, I'll just get back to you when I have this perfect circle. Okay, bye. Okay, so I have the perfect circle, and now just you have to just hot glue that, it's the perfect circle, or your circle, onto the thing, the rest of it, like that. And so it's like that. So now we just need to paint it, so let me just get my paints real quick. Okay, I got my paints, and it's, you know, paint it black, just like the bottom, just like that, and yeah. Just take your paintbrush and just paint the clear hot glue. Well, unless you want the whole thing to be black. I mean, yeah. I accidentally got black and my green. And yeah. Just paint it just like that. And we're gonna add Mod Podge over this later. So yeah. Just like that. There we go. Okay, so I'm just going to get back to you when the paint's dry. Okay, so the paint is dry, and now we're just going to do a design on the front. Well, unless you want to keep it the color that it is, then you can skip this step. But, need to use my X-Acto knife for this one again. It's really hard. The paint just dries on there. Okay, there we go. And didn't come bursting out this time. That's good. So, yeah. Just gonna have to... okay, get this brush. And I'm just gonna use the... I want to try and do it like a watermelon, but that's not really good. Let's see. I'm just gonna paint the whole thing dark green and just see what happens, I guess. Yeah, I don't really know what I'm going to do for this one. But, yeah. I'm just going to try and do polka dots. Probably, and do the same color as the case. So get a bunch of white, like that. And a bunch of this color. And that color came bursting out. And just mix them together. Just like that. A nice magenta color. And that's a darker magenta. But now I'm just going to do polka dots on it. Oh, yeah, that's not going to work. Here, I'm just going to get back to you when I have this all figured out. Okay, bye. Okay, so I have the little pop socket all figured out, and it's a nice little flower pattern. And now you just need to take some glue dots and stick the pop socket on one of the glue dots, just like that, and just stick it on your eyeball case like a regular pop socket, just like that. So yeah, that's pretty much it, but you need to do one more thing. You need to seal the paint. So, sorry if it's blurry, but get some of your Mod Podge. It's really hard to open. There we go. Get some Mod Podge and just coat everything. So, it can stay on forever and ever and ever. No, just kidding. That's what Kiki does, but yeah. So, just cover everything with Mod Podge so the paint doesn't chip off. There's a little bit of green on there. It's fine. Okay, so I'll just get back to you when the Mod Podge is dry. Bye! Okay, so the Mod Podge is dry. And yeah, the Mod Podge is dry. So yeah, I think that's all we need to do. But now we just need to set the little phone in. So yeah. Okay, so that was your video on how to make the little pop sockets and the little phones and iPhone cases. And since this video is a little bit long, I think I'm just going to have a part two on this video where we make the polymer clay cases with the closed pop sockets. So I'll see you later.
Sweet life.